to go through a video with you on how to sleep with a stoma after your post-op surgery. So how do you sleep with your stoma? Well, here's how I sleep with mine. So post-op, coming out of hospital and coming home, you need another week or two for a recovery period, just until you get back onto your feet. And one of the things I think I struggled with most is finding a decent sleeping position with my stoma. And the reason being is everything's swollen, it's a little bit tender. If your bag's filling up, then it can drag and it can pull down on your tummy and you can feel it. So I invested in a maternity pillow. I think this is the second or third one that I've gone through since I've had my stoma. And I take this to hospital with me and I still use it now. Now, the reason being for this is it helps to support my stoma. It also helps me get a comfortable night's sleep. And when my bag does fill up during the night, then it just sort of alleviates the pressure of pulling down on my tummy. So my stoma is here. Oh, sorry, I've just put it down. So my stoma is on the left side. And I have dips and creases on this side. So I've never been completely comfortable because I have had leaks with this and I can never quite get it round the right way to support me over night time and it feels a bit funny. So I sleep on this side and I quite literally, so I do that, I put it between my legs, I have that under and that is how I sleep over night time. It supports my bag, it supports my tummy. And it's just what I find comfortable with how to sleep. Now, if you are worried about night times and the bags filling up, I would say set an alarm system. I'm going to be doing this again in October because my stoma is being refashioned from a loop ileostomy to an end ileostomy. And I'm going to be using the alarm system of wake up, sleepyhead, and go and empty your bag because my output takes time to settle down after I've had the surgery. Typically, I would say empty your stoma just before bed. And I know that in the night time, especially post-op for me, that I need two alarms at the night time. So say I go to bed at 10 o'clock, I would set an alarm for 1 a.m. Just to check my bag and empty it if needed. And then I would set another one for 4 to 5 a.m. just to check it and empty it again, because sometimes the bag can come off if it overfills or it can possibly leak. You may not have these issues. Typically for me, I only really leak post-op overnight. Other than that, with the vitamin E bag, I don't have leaks. Another tip for you would be is Pelican do absorption sachets, so you can stick those into your bag, so if your output is more watery than thick, then two of those will help to gel down the output. So if you've got a full, say your bag's three quarters full and it's pure liquid, with one of these it makes the amount less because it solidifies it, so instead of having a half full bag you'll have a quarter full bag. You can get the little thin support belts which you put on, and what that does is it pushes the base plate down and it holds it in place and holds it intact over night time if you aren't feeling so secure. Post-op for pajamas and stuff, so with me, I typically wear sort of mid-waist pajamas. I would say if you are having surgery to normally go a size up, it just stops it from rubbing on the surgery lines and everything else. And that is how I sleep with a stoma. I would say things that you can do, so if I just show you here, so on my bed I have three protective sheets. So I have a waterproof cover on my mattress, I have a mattress protector, and then I have another sheet which is on top here, which protects the bed if you do so happen to leak. But in other night time, whilst I'm sorting myself out, my partner strips the bed, puts it all in the washing machine and washes it as quick as possible, because the longer you leave it, then that can stain the bed linen, just because of the acidity coming out with regards to the output. With a urostomy, you would typically have a night drainage system. So if it does leak, then the same advice, strip the bed,
put it into the washing machine and wash it and just remake the bed and obviously have a change of appliance. So that is me for how to sleep with a stoma. If you need any advice or any tips, then don't hesitate to inbox me over at Louise@cronesfighting.com, which is my email address, or you can email me on my Facebook, you can message me directly on my Facebook page, or just post a question up on the Pelican page, and I will get back to you as soon as I possibly can. So I'd like to say thank you for watching. You've seen my pyjamas, this is typically how I go to bed, and for those of you that are watching this, if you are just about to have the surgery, I'm wishing you well with the surgery and a speedy recovery. And for those of you that are just post-op, I hope you're resting and getting used to your stoma. So I'd like to say thank you.